Dinosaur Incorporated, and today we will be doing the second rigging tutorial that I have done on the channel. Yes, I will be using a COS model. I made sure to get permission to use it in the video, etc., etc. Alright, so this is the way I find to be the most efficient and easiest way to rig, especially custom models such as, you know, made up creatures, dinosaurs, anything that's not humanoid. And the first thing that I would like to point out is my naming. The thing that makes it so easy with the plugins that I use has to be the naming. Like, you have your head, right? That's the main part of the head. I think for this model, it's just those two little red part, and then every other detail of the head is just gonna be a head S. That way, if you were to, let's just say, move it a little bit, only the head is there, and so everything that's an S will get welded on. That way, when you go to animate it, if there's so many different parts, you only are actually able to click that one head piece, which moves all of it, which I just find to be such an efficient way to get it done. Same works for jaw, leg, ankle, thighs, ears. So I use N1 for neck. NS is all the neck assets, such as details. N2S details, same for N3, etc. Same thing for the tail, same thing for the bodies. And then another thing I want to point out that I didn't say on the other one. So when you make a humanoid, the thing that I find best, especially when it comes to scripting, movement, overall everything, is to make that humanoid such a bigger block than most would, you know, think. I like to put it around behind the back foot, leading up to the top of the body, leaning over front of the paw, see, so it's like right there next to the actual foot, and then extending over most of the model, as you can see. And that's just, it makes it so much easier when scripting. You don't have to mess with hip heights. Overall, it's just really good to use. And alright, let's to get this started, I will link the plugin that I use. I do use a paid version, or I have a paid version, but I won't be using it for the video. I can link both the paid and the free one. The paid one's only like 100 Robux for it. It's not that much. So you want to have your model clicked and get that rigging thing out. I like to go to steps to zero just to make sure it starts off really well. That means, like, if you had a joint and you try to move it, it doesn't move in increments, it moves smoothly. Let's find that humanoid root part, and we will link the humanoid root part up to the middle body. That way, that is the core part of it. I'm blind, sorry guys. Just make a joint, and you don't necessarily have to move the joint, but you are 100% able to do as you see fit with this one. If you think it's going to be rotated in weird ways, maybe make sure it's curved down the middle, etc. Alright, and now I like to just move straight from that part. So you have, select right here, you have the middle body S, select all of those, and you create a weld. That way, when they go to animate, only that middle body is going to be the one that moves. That, like, you only are able to click that part, I guess I should say. I'll go into further when I can actually show you guys with something. So we'll take that middle part, and we'll connect that to the lower body, create that joint. We'll do our best to find, like, the little slit between the between these two parts. Alright, so let's say, just say right about there. Right, you can see it's directly in the middle about. Sometimes, depending on the model, you want to move it a little bit more over. Make sure it's even. And you still, when you want to make it even on this line and through here on the x-axis. It just makes it overall easiest when you move it in any which way. Now that we have the lower body jointed, we can weld every part touching that. And now, so we're going to move on to the tail. The tail, which is T1, goes from lower body to T1. Create that joint, and as you can see right here, there's that little gold little nugget. We're gonna take this, take the joint, move it right about to the middle, over just this tad bit, so that it doesn't rotate based off the middle part, it rotates right around that edge. So it, when you animate it, it creates a nice little smooth. And do note, these can be completely imported into Blender as well. Like, it works in Blender for animations. I find rigging it in Roblox and then importing to Blender for animations is one of the more smoother things to do. All right, now that we have T1, so tail one, we can put those wells on it. T1, T2, create that joint. See, that's that next nugget right here. Move that right about to the middle, up one a little bit. Move it there, perfect. T2, T2S, create those joints. Now, I just wanna make sure that you know everything we're currently doing, so I pull out an animator. Verde Garde, boom. All right, so now you see when you rotate, I only have these things rigged, right? Nothing else will be selectable in the model. So when I move it, it's only those. But it'll rotate now based on the middle of that part. I should probably move it up a little bit. But like right here, this part looks a little bit more smoother, except going up because, you know, M normal, but, or unnatural. And then you have your tail. See a little bit more of a smoother, unless you go too far, obviously, but it doesn't literally break the model when you mess with it, right? Like that. That's not a bad bend. Like, yeah, there's a little bit different because the Tris implements, but it works, right? Looks really good. All right, now that I know those work, I'm gonna finish the rest of the tail. So we bring this thing back out. We were on tail two, so go back down to tail two. Close that so I don't look confused. All right, tail two to tail three. All right, create that joint. That one is still gonna be right here. Right in that little gold nugget. Right up a little bit forward. All right, now we go T3, T3S, weld. All right, T3, T4, create that joint. The most important part about using this method, it's not really a method, it's just a quicker way to rig if you name it all right and use this plugin, because most plugins you can't use Explorer for, and that's why I love Explorer so much with this plugin. It's a literal lifesaver for me. Create that weld for T4, T5, which is almost the ending part. T5, which it looks like that joint's right about there, so we're gonna move this to right before that little crevice line. All right. T5, T5S, create that weld. Now we have T5 to T6, the last part of the tail. As you can see, this one is literally just this part right here. So we can move it to a little bit before, down a little bit. And then we will actually put it right there. Yeah, put it right there. And then we will go T, boom, boom. Get those S's on there for those welds, and now let's check out that tail. Alright, as you can see, the whole thing's working smooth. You are only able to select the parts of the tail that are jointed, which is why everything else will be a weld, so you're not misclicking it. Looking snazzy. Alright, so this one we could probably move a little bit more out. Come down here. Alright, that one needs moved out a little bit more too. And then this part, I'd say that's fine for that. Alright. So just so you guys know, I hate this plugin right now though, it's doing that stupid error. Oh no, I'm gonna go here. Alright. So for this one, we wanted to move it a little bit more that way. Gosh, I'm stuck in the other ones. A little more that way, and the same for this one. We'll move it a little more that way, down a little bit, make it try and as even as possible. Alrighty, looks about good to me. Just so you guys know, for this video, I am only going to do the left leg and the left front leg, just because there's no need to do the entire thing when I can show you all with just that. Or I might just not do the toes on each of them, because toes are really annoying, at least to me. Like, the most annoying part of rigging is when you get to the toes. All right, now that that's all done, we are gonna go find that middle body, which is right here. And now we are going to joint it to the upper body. Create that joint, move that. That joint needs moved down a lot. Move that to right about there, it looks like. All right, as we noticed earlier, this one can be moved up a little bit because it kind of rotated a little weird. All right, Now that we have that upper body jointed, we can go ahead and create those welds. Now we're going to go from upper body to N1, which is what I use for neck. So that's the first neck part. Create that. Find this little diamond crevice right there. We're going to move it right into that as perfect as we can, with only being able to see so much of it. Alright. Before I go any further, just because I don't feel comfortable with that one, we are going to see what it currently looks like. Right, so we have this neck right here. See if it doesn't rotate too weird. We should move it up a little bit so it doesn't curve off that much. Alright, yeah, and then let's check this. That's not bad. Not at all. Just a little abnormal, which every creature model is going to have a little bit of. Alright, let's go ahead and come here. Now that we know this joint needs moved up a little bit, we're going to go up a little bit and then over. Up one more, over one, two more. Alright. I'll move back down a little bit. Right about there. That looks... Actually, no. I'll go up here more. That looks like a better spot to me. I'm not going to lie. I like that one. Now we're going to go back up to N1 to N2. Create that joint. Alright, now again, it's getting a little bit difficult to see, but I think there's a little shape of a diamond right there. So I'm going to go back up-ish right there. This model isn't the most simple to work with. A lot of other ones would be simple and not so many details on the head, so you can actually be able to see it. Alright, now that we have N2, N2S, boom. N2 and 3. Create that joint. Alright, let's take a look. There's the joint. There's the other joint. Right here-ish. So I'm going to move it this way a little bit. Down, over, maybe just leave it like right there. Alright, N3S. Now we're going to go to N3 to head. A lot of things that people mistake with games like these is you don't actually need a fake head part. It's completely unneeded. A lot of games try to make you use them. You don't need them whatsoever. Alright, and so for this head, because it's more of a weird, it's like an oddly shape, I'm going to try and put it right there. We'll see if that works. Alright, now we go to head S, create those welds. Now we're going to go to head to jaw. Create that joint, because you do want the jaw to be movable, obviously. Move that one over a little bit. Maybe that'll work. We'll test it. It's the whole point of rigging. You want to make sure it's perfect before you send it to any animator. Alright, let's give this one a test. The ears are not rigged yet, so the ears might look a little bit funky. Alright. The head. I'd say it's not bad. It's not a bad movement for the head. See what it looks like moving from the neck. Alright, so yeah, I'll move it down a little bit so it rotates less on the up in the higher part. Or move it up a little bit. Let's test this jaw. That was a good first spot for a jaw, I'm not gonna lie. I would take that any day of the week if you ask me. Rawr. Alright. Does look like there's a little like weird part sticking out of the model, but I'll figure that part out once I get to a little bit further on. Alright, so we had that little issue with the head one needs moved up a little bit. Let's see if that worked. And if you guys wonder why I'm getting like all these other little dots, the easiest way to fix that is you click the model, you have it up here. If you go to your properties, you click your primary part. Scroll down to your model's humanoid root part and select that. You want to do that anyways, almost no matter what. But that way when I go here, it goes pretty much straight to that one. Straight to that. Alright. I'm Unless there's another part anchored, sometimes it'll try and pick other parts that are anchored and try and put it as like the, assume it's the primary part, even if it's not even close, type of thing. Alright. Just want to test that one out for you. And this is, it's, again, rigging isn't hard, it's all about where you're at in it. That's a big thing. Alright, head. Oh yeah, I'm liking that one a little bit more. Okay. And then rar. Okay. Alright, I'm liking that one so far. Now we can go ahead and get these ears rigged. Kind of funky little things. So we have head. So you don't usually have to animate ears, but this is like a jackalope or whatever you call them. So we have left ear one, and then we can find the right ear. And the thing I like is you can co-pick parts like this for creating joints and move them at the same time. Like that's just, it's like a lifesaver. Move it over here, put that up a little bit, and all right, now select them separately, move them in and around as you see fit. I think this one's moved in now. Up a little bit, actually. Alright, that was just the ear one parts. So now that we have ear one, I'll do each ear separately just so you guys both get like the full realization with it. Alright, so ear one has ear one S, has a few ear S's. So let's create those welds. And just see the way the plugin works, like, so I'll go ear one, ear two. Create that joint, and it creates a joint from this thing to that. And since this little triangle is right there, we'll move that to, where's that little dot? Right about there-ish. Nah, I lied. It's kind of hard to see sometimes. Because you also got to stay out of that little bubbles area sometimes. Alright, that looks about right to me. And then what I was going to say is welding, like, the first part you pick is the mother part, the thing that everything else will go to. Like, you have all these ears, ear S, right? Since this was part one, the mother part, create the welds, it all goes to that. They're all connected to this piece. It's one of the, just, I find to be the easiest things in the entire world, right? Let's unselect all those parts. Animator. And one thing you guys might want to do just to make sure, like, hey, I don't want the model to break, because sometimes the animators do break them. If you've done a good amount of progress, Control D, copy the model, and then move one a little bit away, just so in case it breaks, you know, you have that backup to go to. So you're not losing, you know, every single part of the progress. So we are going to go to Anime Editor. This is Legacy Animations. This is not the default Roblox one. I find it to be a little better and less choppy. I can link this one in the description for you guys as well. Alright, so we have this ear. Wee, 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 wee. Right, and then you have this little part to him. Let's see how well he did on that joint. Alright, so he's moved out a little bit, but other than that, like, you're not going to do crazy things on that, so it'll work. Alright, rig editor. Find that right ear. Right ear one, right ear one as well. Alright, now we're on this ear. Now we're gonna go right ear one, right ear two, create that joint, move that joint over to the right, go a little bit more, move it over, about the middle-ish. Alright, and maybe down just a tad bit. Alright, ear two. Ear 2S, create weld. Now the ear, pretty much everything on this body is done, except for some limbs. Like I said, I'm only gonna do one side of the limbs, on at least the toes, because they suck. I'll show you guys an easy way to make sure you at least get both sides pretty close to lined up on your joints, because it's pretty important to have both, like, the left leg and the right leg on the back, to have even joints throughout the entire thing. Let me go find that lower body right here. Now we're gonna find left and right thigh. Left, oh, nope. Ah, left back. LB at left back. And then RB for right back thigh. Right back thigh, all right. Now we're going to create joint. Now you'll see it'll create a joint on both sides, which is what we wanted it to do. Then we can move this one accordingly to how we want to move it, which I like to go not at the top of this because then it will move a little weird, but kind of like, I want to say right about there, because the model goes, oh my god, the model goes around like that, around like this. And if you have it kind of close to the top-ish, but not all the way up there, it's kind of just like a good send-off point, I feel like. I'll show you guys once we get further on. And then now that we have that, we can go to, so we have right back thigh to right back calf, because that's the next part that would be movable. And then you're going to want to create joint. And then what I like to do is I go back down to right back thigh to right back calf, create joint, select this one and select this one, and then move them accordingly. Like, it'd be like right about here. Right about there, I wanna say. Move down a little bit. All right, that might be a good spot. We'll see when we can move it more. Ankles and wrists are a little bit trickier than the rest of the body. The rest of the body is probably the easiest thing in the entire world to figure out. All righty. So now that we have those two, I'll go back up to like right thigh S, create those, right back calf, create those, go all the way back down again to right back thigh, create those welds, right back calf, to create those welds. Now we will go to right back calf, I think it's right back wrist, or ankle, right back calf, right back ankle, boom, create that one down there. Go back up here to right left back calf to left back ankle, create that joint. Now we're gonna do the same thing we did on the calf. Select both of those parts. We have both of these selected. We're gonna move them up to the ankle area. Right about there, I think is a good spot. A lot of rigging is just seeing how, where you can position the joints where they look the best and move the best. I'm not big on anatomy. I don't know much about anatomy, but rigging was just one of the first things I learned on Roblox Studio. Right back ankle S, boom. Go back up to left. Left back ankle to left back ankle S, all of them, boom. Now we have left back ankle to left back foot. Boom. To go back down to the right. Right ankle, right foot, create that joint, go back up. I scroll too far up. Sorry guys, I'm a little slow sometimes. To the foot, both sides. Now this part might be more of just wherever you can get it to look best at. At least in my opinion, it's more like that. Right about there. All right, and then after we get that left back foot done, right, we can go find that foot again, foot S, whatever detail is with it, boom, back down to the right. Right back foot S, which is just gonna be the foot and this little gold part, create that weld. All right, and let's just say, I want to take a sneak peek at what it currently looks like, but I don't want to lose that progress. Remember, you can always delete that old one, take this, control D to duplicate. Move that bad boy away, open that up, get your animation thing open, and just see where it's at. Like, that's not bad rotation on it, if this animation thing would work. Like, that's not bad. See how this thing exits out. It's not bad at all there either. Just can't go too far because it chips, which is just the model sometimes. All right, now we have this ankle. All right, so the ankle, can't tell if it's gonna be stuck with that or if I should move it a little bit. I might move it just to make it a little bit less. Yeah, I'll move it more to the left, to the right. All right, now let's check that foot. Sometimes those don't like to work. All right, that foot, that's a good spot. I'll move it up a little bit. All right, see. It's not that hard. Click that model, open this rig editor back up. Let's go to the left side of this bad boy and let's work on these feet. Because he definitely has some feet problems, alright? Alright, left back foot to left back toe 1, toe 2, and toe 3. Oh, and toe 4. Create that joint. For these ones, you can kind of all move them back a little bit. And then you want to go through and individually move them to where you think that they just need to go. Like that one's kind of more in there a little bit like that. That one just needs moved back a little bit. And probably... Yeah, I'd say over a little bit as well. This one needs moved back. And over. It's that bigger looking toe. This one needs moved over. Back and back the other way a little bit. Oh, that's way too far back. Hold up. Oh, actually. That might be maybe moved up a little bit. I think they all... might have moved up a little bit. Alright, a tad bit. Alrighty. Then we have toe 1 to toe nail. Oh, there's only one toe part in all this. So one toe, toe S, weld, toe 2, toe nail, toe S, weld. Toe 3 nail, toe S, weld. Sometimes, if you wanted to, you could joint the nail so you, like, the nail is movable. But that kind of just looks a little bit funky, you know? Alright, now that is looking not too snabby. Alright, since I did that left foot, I won't be doing this one on the toes, but I will do this full one just to make sure you guys fully see it and can understand. So now... I'm not going to do the double thing on the back bar. I just want to make sure you guys are able to fully see it. I might post a model in the description that is not from COS, but from something of my own. If you guys need to take a look at like how I run it and the naming and just the way the joints, I might post it. We'll see. I haven't made up my mind yet about that part. So now we're going to find that upper body. Go through and find right front, left. I think I named it arm. We'll see. I kind of like rigged this a while ago. Left front calf. Is that it? All right. Left front calf. Create that joint. The calf. Oh, wait a minute. I might be crazy. Right body. Two. Do I have a left front thigh? I do have a left front thigh. I was crazy. All right. Let's create that joint. Move it up. That way a little bit. A little bit over and boom. There we go on that. Left front thigh. Left thigh S. Boom. Alright, now I have left thigh to the left calf. Create that joint. So this one again, it's kind of like a sharp just straight across. So this one might be choppy no matter what I try to pull off with the jointing. Alright. Left front calf, not chi. Alright, create that weld. Now what's after the calf? Left front ankle. It is not the ankle. What did I name that? Left front. Left front. Leg. That was it. I rigged this like 2 years ago for COS, so I apologize for all the confusion. I'm a little bit crazy. Alright, where's that joint at? Alright, that joint is right, almost right there. Let's move that over, down, probably down a little bit actually. Alright, we'll see how that one turns out. Left leg S, create that weld. Now we have left leg to left front ankle. Alright, so let's move this part. Let's move it up. See the diamonds back here, but you still want to go in the middle of the leg. That way you can still make sure it moves a little bit more evenly across the whole thing. Alright. Now we have that left front ankle S. Boom, guys, we're almost done. I know I didn't rig the entire thing, but this is overall just to show you an example of what I think is the most efficient way of rigging in 2024. All right, so I have that left front ankle to the left front foot. Boom, boom, chala. All right, so that one's about right there. Move this up, over, down a little bit more. All right, left front foot doesn't seem to have any parts with it. So let's give this one a quick test, because again, I don't want to lose my progress on the model, right? Like, I've already rigged it. Control D, bring that bad boy all the way over there. Test the animations on this bad boy. How's that front thigh move? I'd say it's not a bad rotation form. Actually, it might be a little too high. Kind of moves like right here, so I'll move it to be like right there. If this stupid animator wants to work, all right, screw it. All right, so we have that calf. See the calf, like I was saying, there's not much we can really do with it because just the way the sharp it is and the curve of it. So that's gonna be a little choppy either way. Let's check that ankle. All right, again, ankle's not that bad. It kind of moves right between the first. Can't go too. Yeah, like I was saying, moves kind of right between that first. You know, if there's any weird cutouts, it's because I'm gonna try and cut out anytime my YouTube goes into an ad. Like having that background noise just so it doesn't feel like it's just me. I don't know. Maybe I'm weird for that, but I am a little weird though, so I'll take it as a compliment, I guess. Let's see if we get it to where it'll let us edit that foot. This animator is really junky in Roblox Studio, I'm not gonna lie. It doesn't like me very much. Alright. That one is not a bad rotation at all, honestly. I like that one. This foot, it'll be easier to see once we get some toes on there, but that's a pretty good one. I like it. I like what I'm seeing. Alright, let's go back up to this top joint. Yeah, I did move that way too far up. Let's move it down and over here a little bit. That one, I'm going to try move it down a little bit. Again, with this one, it's kind of harder. We'll see in the end, though. All right, we were on that left front foot, left front toe one, left front toe two, toe three, toe four. All right, create those bad boy joints. Let's move these up a little bit. Move them back. All right, now we were gonna move them to where we think they should be. This way, maybe front, a little more, a little bit on the center. Then this one doesn't go down a little bit. This one definitely over more. That actually might be the better spot that I could put that. Maybe back. Alright, we'll test it. Alright, this one needs to move back and up a little bit more. Oh, I lied. And it needs to move over this way. This one needs moved a little over that way, a little back, and a little up. Alright. Now let's get those toes. Toe one nail, toe two S, boom. Toe two, toe nail, toe three S, boom. Three weld, boom. And four weld, boom. Let's give those bad boys a little test. Since this is all I'm gonna show for the video, I'm gonna do my final copy over there, take this one and test out these animations. All right, so let's create that look, see if this one turned out any better. All right, that one is honestly a lot better than where it was. All right, now, see, again, I don't know if the calf really helped at all. I guess a little bit from what it was. Not much we can really do. This was fine before. All right, let's see that foot with these things on there. I think that's a pretty good joint for the foot. All right. See if the toe's weird. All right. See if like somebody wanted to spread it out a little bit. I wouldn't spread it out. That's not too bad. Not too bad at all. All right, guys. And I believe that is going to be it for the video. I know This might be a short one. Probably not, actually. I've been recording for 36 minutes. Alright, that's gonna be a wrap. Anyways, if you guys want to see more of this, make sure to comment down below. Let me know. I don't know what else I would do. I do plan to further the scripting tutorials I did. I did one. Kind of didn't get many views, so I kind of was like, eh, whatever. I'll leave it be. But I know my other rigging tutorial did really good, so I thought might as well make a more complex one. Something I find to be the most efficient, especially for more custom models such as this. Again, just want to say thank you to Wolfragon, the current game director of COS, for giving me permission to use this in the video. It really helped me find just a good model that people would recognize and had the things I needed to check off the list. Anyways, guys, thank you so much. Have a wonderful day.